Boom eyes, I'm not afraid to let go. You decide if you're ever gonna let me know. Yeah, suicide if you ever try to let go. I'm sad to know, yeah. I'm sad to know, yeah. Oh, hey, buff. Never mind, that was trying to eat. That was trying to eat.
I was about to throw my shit.
Nah, you right, babe.
I'm gonna heal up here. I'll be back with you if I'm done healing.
That Pathfinder weak. Oh, he coming up now. Oh, that's another. That's the caustic use fighting.
Reloading. Coming back. Oh, what you doing, bro? You think you have a bigger brain? Your brain is tiny. And then look at you trying to pull a bomb.
There's still people here. Where are they?
Knock a mirage. No! Suck dick! I'm fucked. What's going on, everybody? It's Jura the Goat back here today with my Season 5 settings. And these are my Season 5 settings to give you aimbot, laser aim, whatever you want to call it. I think you can get it if you play in these settings. So let's hop right into settings. So for the prompt style, it's compact so you don't have all the extra information that you don't need on your screen. And I play on that. I press the things better. Button hints, I have those on. I don't know what those do. Oh, stupid stuff. Never mind. You don't need that on if you don't want. Crosshair damage feedback with shield icon, of course. That's the only one I'm going to ever play on. Not going to change it. Damage numbers on stacking. If you put it on floating, you have to like basically it tells you how much damage you hit per shot, and it doesn't add all up together, which is stupid. Both on is just too much on your screen. Stacking gives you your end total damage after hitting your bullets. Off, people put that on, they say they have better tracking. I don't think so. Ping opacity default, doesn't matter in my opinion. Obituaries on, minimap rotation off. Weapon auto cycle on empty. I have that off because if it's on and you run out of ammo in that clip, it's going to switch the other gun, which is really, really dumb because what if you want to reload that gun and keep using it and you have time to reload it? So I have it off. Auto sprint off, and every game that it lets me have it on, I turn it off. It messes up, in my opinion. It messes me up. Double tap sprint, I don't like that either. Incoming damage feedback, I suggest you have that on 3D. That's just me. I don't like the 2D, and I definitely don't want both on. Taking damage closes death box. Alright, this one's controversial, right? So, if you have it on, whenever you take any type of damage, you're going to get kicked out of the death box for looting. I put that on because sometimes I don't fully pay attention. You could be getting burned by a thermite or getting shot, and you don't know, and you can't get out of the box in time. But if you have it off, and you're getting shot at or burned, you won't know, so you're gonna die in the death box. At least with it on, you'll get taken out when you start taking damage. It's only good when you're in the storm and you want to loot and stuff like that. Streamer mode off, that's stupid. Usage sharing, that's, I don't care about that. Colorblind mode, the one all the way to the right. Ever since I put it on, I don't know why, I play the game way better now. I see things differently, I see them better, and it's an overall better experience. Subtitles don't matter. If you want it on, you can put it on. That doesn't matter. Controller, button layout. I play on default. I was thinking of switching to Evolved because Evolved is just like way better, I heard. I don't know why. Or I might do customized, actually. I'll probably do customized if I switch. But right now, default I play on. Stick layout is default. Interact reload button will always be tapped to use and reload. Crouch button toggle. So toggle is if you press it, you stay down. And if you hold, you have to hold to stay down in crouch mode. And once you let it go, you pop back up. Same for the aim down. If you hold, you literally just tap it once and you hold it down. Toggle, you tap it and you stay aimed in basically. As long as you're holding. L2, R2, dead zones off so you don't have any type of delay on your bullets. Whenever you press it, you press it. Menu cursor speed. I have mine high. This is all preference right here. I like playing on the high. You loot fast. And it makes your looting faster in death boxes. And scrolling through stuff. Movement dead zone small. You're going to want to put that on small. Invert look. I can't can't play on that, if you can play on that, let me know down in the comments, and you're a god if you do, and you actually do good on it. Vibration, off, always off. It can mess you up in gunfights or stuff like that. I think it messed me up in gunfights, so I don't use it. See, personally, I play on advanced lick controls. I don't play on normal settings, so my dead zone is right there. You don't want it there, where I have it, and lower, it has a little bit of drift, but it's not bad at all. And maybe it's my controller, I'm thinking about getting a new controller. Outer threshold, you want that on nothing. Response curve, all preference here. You gotta tweak it to how you want it and find your sweet spot. Per optic settings, I don't use that. Yaw speed and pitch speed, that's how quick you look left and right, up and down. That's basically your normal sensitivity. I have mine on max. I don't mess with these. Don't mess with those either. ADS yaw speed and pitch speed, it's basically your aim down sights when you're looking left and right, up and down. I have mine one click off being max. I turn it down to see if it doesn't make a difference. I don't think it does, so I'm going to turn it back up, to be honest. And this is the same thing up there with the turning. It's I don't mess with that. Ramp up, I don't mess with that. Target compensation on. Melee target compensation on. You want both those on. Video. Field of view, 110. You see everything. You want that on. You want this. You need this. This. Sprint view shake, minimal. You want this, and you need this too. I promise you, it'll put your gameplay home much better if you don't use it. And audio is up to you guys. That's all personal preference there too. Alright guys, this has been Dior the Goat in my controller Apex settings video. And comment down below, leave a like, sub, share with your friends, and I'll be back for a video next time. I'll see you guys.